So what is heat flux, and is it a scalar or a vector quantity? If it is a vector, how do we define its direction? So there are a couple of small basic level questions, and we'll try to cover everything which is related to heat flux. So the topic is heat flux. So as I defined earlier, heat flux is symbolized as Q double dash, and the heat flux is defined as rate of heat transfer per unit area. Okay, so that is a very basic and simple formula. So we can say heat flux is a normalized kind of heat transfer rate, or rate of heat transfer, because we are dividing it with area through which that rate heat transfer is occurring. Okay, and first, it is a directional quantity. Okay, and how do we define direction then? How or what's the direction? Okay, so that may be a big question for you. So that is defined by the direction is being the normal to the cross-sectional area A, and it is in the direction of decreasing temperature. So direction of heat transfer will always be normal to isothermal surfaces. The concept of isothermal surface is in it, the heat rate of heat transfer being perpendicular to it or normal to it have been explained earlier also, but let's look at this again. So as I said, the direction of Q, direction is normal to a heat transfer area, that is, this is the area, or otherwise if we say that my heat transfer is occurring to through this, it can be irregular shape also. So if it is occurring through this area, and the normal to this area is this, then I can say my Q double dash direction is also in the direction of n cap. Okay, so that is the concept. And the other thing which I said, that the direction of heat transfer is perpendicular or normal to the isothermal surface, that means if my surface is T1, another surface is T2 over here, and let's assume T2 is less than T1, that means my heat transfer will occur from T1 to T2, and the direction will be perpendicular. So this will be 90 degrees, and this will be the direction of Q double dash heat flux. Okay, so that's the simplest thing. And as I used earlier, if this is the x direction, then Q double dash x will be defined as minus k dt by dx. This subscript x represents that I am writing the heat flux in that direction. Okay, and this is a generalized one. This is a specific one for one direction, and my k value has not been taken a much of special consideration as yet. So we'll think what the k value should be. So k value may be different for anisotropic materials. So over here we'll have k1, k2, etc. for anisotropic materials. But for isotropic materials there is only one k, that is k equal in all direction, then it is said as we have isotropic material. And generally we will not find any question related to heat transfer where we are given with multiple different values of k. For any material, we'll always be assuming that it is isotropic material, and hence my k value is same in all direction. Hence if when we write the heat flux in different direction, that means if this is my total heat flux, and it will include the multiple k and which represents like this qx double dash I cap plus qy direction heat flux j cap plus qz direction k cap. Okay, so these are the three addition of three perpendicular heat flux to give a heat flux, a net heat flux. So over here I'll use kx, here over here I'll use ky, over here the formula should include kz. But for an isotropic material, these all three k values will be equal, and hence I can write them as k directly. So that is a simplification for us. And as I gave earlier, if this is a surface and n cap is was our direction, then my heat flux can be generalized like this. That is for n direction. We can write the formula like this. So this was the basics about heat flux. It's a directional quantity, and how we define the direction is defined over here. The formula is over here, that is q double dash is equal to q dot upon a. The q dot has the formula of watt and a has the meter square. Hence the flux has the value units of meter square. So any flux, if it is a magnetic flux or electric flux, the unit remains the same. That is the numerator may change, but the denominator must have the meter square. So that is everything, the quantity. So in that also, if we are defining electric flux or current flux, that means it will have amperes upon meter square, area, or amperes per meter square. So anything will, when we are defining flux, it's per unit area. That's right. Okay, thank you.